the old houses, and you mold everyone in the side, inside, outside. So yeah, I'll ask me. The next one, if you get, if it's a new house, and they're
performing. So you also, like, came like, the public, or they can come?
Yeah, I
You did? Wow.
You have a chicken people?
Yeah. No.
Oh, it's awesome.
But it's so cool.
Maybe, yeah.
And it's the best part of the
World War.
What is this?
Like you said.
Thank God.
Oh, that is good.
Yeah.
But the kids know about
the
part
of what yeah. Yeah. Most of the time, I'm not doing anything.
I'm
just talking.
You could have broken it.
Huh?
It does come out.
No, I've lost some recently.
All
the guys are
American. Today we will study chapter 5, effective listening skills. And we will study, these are the objectives of today's lesson. Understand the listening process, describe the importance of listening, identify the listening styles, discuss the listening barriers, and explain effective listening skills. So here, my question here is that, do you think listening is important? Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Then when we fail to listen, what would it happen? What do you think?
Miscommunication.
Miscommunication?
Yeah.
Yeah. What else? Yeah. We all have experience. Someone did not listen.
Problem.
Yeah. Problem. Yeah. So right. So yeah, it causes a lot of problems. Sometimes we suffer a relationship that we have, or a partner may leave us. Other times our job can be dangerous on the line. Okay, so yeah, a lot of problem occurs. So listening is important. Here, so here my another question is, what is the difference between hearing and listening? They are different. Hearing and listening. What is the difference between hearing and listening?
Hearing is just not stay focused.
Yeah, ooh!
Just the hearing.
Yes, like,
That's it, because the hearing.
You guys are late.
Yeah, we know we're late.
Are you?
Yeah, wait. We have to do this. It's another day to apply for a new passport.
Yeah.
So we have an appointment in maybe 12, so we now have to go to Los Angeles. So.
Listening and hearing is
physical process of relating in audible stimuli without focusing on, you said without focus on stimuli. For example, when you hear a car sound outside, it is hearing. You don't need to pay attention. Yeah, pay attention. Just you can hear. That's hearing. But listening is dynamic transactional process of receiving, recalling, reading, and responding to stimuli, messages of force. So when you listen, you have to pay attention at these differences between hearing and listening. For example, you listen to music, it means that you pay attention to the music, right? So, then listening process. There are four components of listening process: receiving, responding, recalling, reading. Receiving is the verbal and nonverbal acknowledgement of message. Responding is providing observer's feedback to a sender's message. Recording, understanding a message, storing it for future encounters, and remembering it later. Rating, evaluating or assessing the message. So there are four components of listening process. And why we listen, you said that listening is important, and we should listen to someone when we communicate with someone. So listening is important. Listening is used to at least three times as much as speaking, and at least four times as much as reading and writing. Yeah. So yeah, listening is essential. It's important to our relationship with others. If someone listens to me well, then maybe you say more, right? Your relationship gets better. But if your friend don't listen to you, then maybe it's a little hard to develop relationship with each other. So listening is essential to our relationship with others. And employers rank listening as the most important skills on the job. And listening has been called 21st century skills because it is now more important than ever. So it's very important. So yeah, why we listen? Listening for information, listening for advice, listening for enjoyment, listening for help others, listening for cultural understanding. Yeah. All these things. When I say something, you should listen to me, right? I see people, use the cell phone. It seems like you don't listen to me, so listen to me, okay? Okay, so listening styles. Researchers have identified four listening styles. First one, people-centered listening style. Okay, the style associated with being centered with other people's feeling or emotion. People-oriented listeners try to compromise and find common areas of interest. They notice others' mood and provide clear verbal and nonverbal feedback. They are less anxious in groups and interpersonal situations. So these people are focused on people. Yeah? People-centered listening style. Second one is action-centered listening style. Okay? Action-centered listeners want messages to be highly organized and concise and error-free. That's their focus. Those people help speakers focus on what is important in the message. They want speakers to get to the point. They grow impatient when people tell stories in the disorganized or random fashion.
welcome complex and challenging information from a sender. However, they may intimidate others by asking pointed questions. You know the attorney, right? Lawyer. Lawyers usually take this style. Yeah? The content-centered listening style. So lawyers and others in the legal professional are likely to prefer this style of listening. Yeah? And lastly, time-centered listening style. Time-centered listeners let others know the messages should be succinctly. Succinctly means briefly. Okay? So they discourage wordy explanations from speakers and set time guidelines for conversations, such as, you know, I have only 5 minutes to talk. Maybe you can say the point in a 5 minutes. So time-oriented listening styles. So we learned four listening styles: people-oriented, action-centered, and content-centered, time-oriented listening style. What about your listening style?
Or pray
textures that distort the message meaning. For example, if your sister is faithful Christian, most of Christians disagree of abortion. Do you know abortion? So then maybe you, if your sister is a faithful Christian, you may avoid any conversation with her about right to the abortion, since Christian condemns abortion. So that case, psychological noise. Yeah. And yeah, so there are many different kind of noises. Because of these noises, it's hard for you to listen. Yeah, when you communicate with others. And message number two, message of love. It occurs when senders receive more messages than they can process. For example, there is a receptionist. Her daily task included reading about 20 mails, listening to 10 voicemails, opening about 50 pieces of mail, and answering about 40 phone calls. Then a certain minister came and asked her with advice how to organize church picnic. Then you know her message overload. It was hard for her to focus on minister's request. Yeah. So message overload. And three. Message complexity. Message complexity means that messages we receive that are filled with detail, unfamiliar language, challenging argument are hard to understand. For example, Dr. Gibb, yeah, tells her patient Mark that his systematic diagnosis has prevented any follow-up. Then for Mark, it was very hard him to understand her explanation. And you know, it can be message complexity. Yeah. Lack of training. So listening is a learned activity, but many schools and companies don't provide a course of listening training. So people lack training in listening skills. So I think, you know, I mean, for you also have a chance to learn how to listen effectively. It's very nice. But then, you know, many people don't know effective listening skill. So that's why, you know, they feel difficulty in listening. And another one is preoccupation. So if you are preoccupied with something, such as your rent, your vacation plan, while you are talking with someone, you cannot listen to others because you are already preoccupied with something, right? So for example, last, you're preoccupied with your baby. It's hard for you to concentrate on studying, something like that, right? So yeah, listening barriers.
Okay.
See
you next time.
Bye. Thank you for coming. Okay.
Of course. Every week.
And six, listening gap. Listening gap is time between time differences between your mental ability to interpret word and the space at which they arrive to your brain. Company, one goes, the other comes. So generally we think about 3 or 4 times faster than we can talk. How are you today?
Good.
Yeah. You're tired? So tired. So when we have a large listening gap, we may daydreaming, yeah, or wondering our mind. It causes to have a difficulty in listening. So let's recap. Listening barriers.
all of them.
Ah,
yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, see.
Seriously.
Oh, really? Okay. What about Nas?
Five.
Five? Yes, I guess. Yeah. So, do you think, you know, do you have any listening barriers?
Maybe the first one.
First
one,
noise.
Noise, yeah.
Okay. Especially what kind of noise?
Physical noise.
Okay.
Yeah.
So maybe you need to take rest. Okay. Then effective. Okay. Before this, effective listening skills. There are five skills for improving listening. First one, listening comprehensive skills. Number two, empathetic listening skills. Number three, critical listening skills. Number four, responding skills. Five, empathetic responding skills. So let's study. First one, improving listening comprehensive skills. Okay, most of the listening problem are because we focus on ourselves rather than on the message of others. So in order to improve listening comprehensive skills, we should be more other-oriented listeners by following steps. Stop focusing on your own mental messages and be more other-oriented. And then look to listen with your eyes as well as your ears. Yeah, look. And then listen. Is to do more than focus on facts and message details. It is searching for essence of speaker's thought. Okay, so listen fully. That way you can improve your listening comprehension skills. Okay. Number two, improving empathetic listening skill. Empathetic. So here, the core of being other oriented is cultivating empathy. So empathy means, empathy is the emotional reaction of feeling what other person is feeling, right? So then. How do we enhance your empathetic listening skill? So here, first think about what the other person may be thinking by socially decentering. Social decentering means the cognitive process of taking into account another person's thought. So we have to think about what others think and think how you would react in the given situation. Think how the other would react. Anyway, you have to be other-centered. And then think about what other person may be thinking. And number two, focusing on feelings and emotions of your partner, truly empathizing with other person. So here, thinking and then focus on feeling. So focus on what others feel, look for nonverbal cues that express emotion, and listen for the meaning of word and meaning behind the word, and respond actively. Yeah. Then maybe it helps you to improve empathetic listening skills. So I will explain it in detail later. So number two. Number three, improving critical listening skills. Critical listening is listening to evaluate and assess the quality, appropriateness, value, or importance of information. So here you need to understand the information clearly and then examine the logic or reasoning used in the message and be mindful of the conclusion based on the factors. These factors will help you to improve critical listening skills. Especially students need this skill, critical listening skills. Yeah. Hello. your point. Let the other person finish his or her point. You have to be wait until the other person finish. So don't interrupt others talking. Second, ask appropriate questions. And so after listening to someone share information, you can ask appropriate questions to get additional details you may have missed and to make sure you understood the message. Yeah? So ask appropriate questions. So according to the researchers, when speakers had a listener who asked questions and made specific responses in a meaningful way, the speakers were better at telling their story. If there is no response to the speaker, the speaker told the story less effectively. So ask appropriate questions. 3. Accurately paraphrase. The only way to know whether you understand another person's message is to check your understanding of the facts and ideas by paraphrasing your understanding. You can respond with a statement such as, "Are you saying this?" Yeah. And then you seem to be describing this. Is it right? Or here is what I understand. You mean something? Is it okay? You need to, use the accurate paraphrase so that you know you have to understand correctly. Another example. Jane and not here, but I will just listen. This is conversation between Jane and Amy. Okay, Jane said, "This week I have so much extra work to do. I am sorry if I haven't been able to help keep this place clean. I know it is my turn to do these dishes, but I have to get back to work. Could you do the dishes tonight?" Amy said, "So you want me to do the dishes tonight and for the rest of the week, right?" So, Amy is using paraphrasing, And then, she's asking, "You want me to do the dishes tonight and for the rest of the week, right?" Checking. And then Jay said, "Well, I would want you to help me with the dishes tonight, but I think I can handle it for the rest of the week." Yeah, Amy said, "Okay, so I will do them tonight and you take over tomorrow." Yes, like this. It's very important. Okay, use paraphrase and then check your understanding. And number 4, provide well-timed responses. Feedback is usually most effective when you offer it at earliest opportunities, particularly if your objective is to teach someone a skill. For example, if you are teaching your friend how to make your famous egg roll, then maybe your friend you provide a step-by-step instructions as you watch your student. But if your student make some mistake, then maybe you can interrupt immediately, and then you can correct, and you can teach. That way, your friend to make the egg roll well, right? So in this case, you can teach. I mean, you can offer the information in an earliest step. But however, sometimes if a person is already sensitive and upset about something, then you need to wait. Wait that your friend could be calmed down, and then emotionally okay, then maybe you can give advice, or you can give a feedback or like that. So provide well timed responses. Okay.
And five, useful information. Yeah, of course. When you provide information to someone, be sure that it is useful and relative, right? Six, avoid unnecessary detail. Yeah? When you are selecting meaningful information, try to cut down on the volume of information and don't overwhelm your listeners with details that obscure the key point of your feedback. So hit only point that will benefit the listeners. So avoid unnecessary details. Get the point. Okay, get the main point. And number seven, be descriptive rather than evaluative. For example, when your friend doesn't drive well, you shout to him, "Wow, you are a bad driver." That's evaluate. Evaluative does not work to others. So then you just give a simple feedback. Okay, like for example, maybe you can something like that. Wow, you can give a simple feedback. Or I give another example, maybe your friend will not respond if you, I will give you a descriptive example. Maybe you can say something like that. Maybe I will get nervous, yeah, when you zigzag so fast from the freeway traffic. Or you are traveling 70 miles an hour in a 50 miles an hour zone. So that way is you know, descriptive. If you say descriptive, you know, your friend may understand more, accept more. But if you judge, if you evaluate something, then you know it does not work. You know, others don't listen to your advice or feedback. So it's always better to give descriptive. Or if you want to give evaluation, very simple, specific, yeah, then it will be effective. Okay. So here, improving responding skills. Don't interrupt. Ask appropriate questions. Accurately paraphrase. Provide well-timed responses. Provide useful information. Avoid unnecessary details. Be descriptive rather than evaluate. And then, improving empathetic responding skills. Before we study about empathetic skills, here is empathetic responding skills. You can use paraphrase emotion, something like this. So you are feeling something, or you must feel something. So now you feel something. Focus on other emotion, right? So So see, this is example. See here, David, Mike. Conversation between Dave and Mike. So Lee, can you read David's part? David's part here. Can you see this?
I think I'm in over my head. My boss gave me a job to do. I just don't know how to do it. I'm afraid I've bitten off more than I can chew.
Thinks how he would feel if he were given an important task at work but did not know how to complete the task, then asks for more information.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, do I need to read that or just the...
Yes.
What did she ask you to do?
Yeah.
I'm supposed to do an inventory of all the items in the warehouse on the new computer system and have it finished by the end of the week. I don't have the forget the notion of how to start. I've never even used that system.
So you feel panicked because you might not have enough time to learn the system and do the inventory?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm not only panicked.
Mm-hmm.
I'm afraid I may be fired.
Fired, I'm sorry.
Fired.
Yeah.
So your fear that you might lose your job is getting in the way of just focusing on the task and seeing what you can get done. It's making you feel like you made a mistake in taking the job.
So here, see here this conversation. So I mean, see the what did she ask you to do? So this one is, you know, Mike is, you know, ask for more information, right? And then next, another Mike's part, summarize the feeling. So he listened to what they said and then summarize his feeling, emphasizing, okay? Think and then focus on feeling, and then he's saying, so you feel panic. He understands his feeling, right? Panic. And because you may not have enough time to learn the system and do the inventory. Again, you know, my part. So he said, you are fear that you might lose yourself. Yeah, during conversation, also he knew David's feeling, fear. Yes, fear. And then even, you know, lose your weight, lose your job is getting in a way of just focusing on the task, seeing what you can do, get done. It's making you feel like you made a mistake in taking the job. So you will see in this conversation, so Mike focus on others' thought and also even, you know, feel others' feeling and empathize. So we need this kind of, you know, skill. So the skill is said what? Responding skill. We feel what others think. If you don't have enough information, ask. And then, you know, also we feel what others' emotion. And then, you know, we can empathize others' feelings. Wow, that's why you feel so sad. You were worried or in a panic. And then, yeah. So then maybe this listening will be effective. So. And what about in your listening, do you use empathetic listening skill? Or do you use this skill often, or you don't? What about, what do you think? Do you use?
I try to
use it, yeah. Yeah, then maybe we will practice, okay? So I will give you just a short time, make a partner, you to try to practice, practice using empathetic responding skill. So one person will share about their anxiety or anything, share, and another person use these skills, yeah? And try to practice effective empathetic listening skill. So it's better to make a pair.
So you must answer with that?
No, what one person will share about something, then the other person listen, not like exactly, but you know, try to think other person's thought, try to you know, emphasize others' feeling.
Can I make an example with you? Because I don't understand.
You don't understand? Okay, now.
Okay.
Maybe you can share about
what?
Anything about your story or your case,
something,
your situation, then maybe, you know, I can try.
Okay. Do I need to tell you something that makes me nervous or sad?
Anything in your current situation. Maybe you can just bring your case. Then another person listen, something. And then maybe try. Like, you know, we saw this David and Mike's conversation.
Okay.
So, yeah. Okay, just hang on. I will show this one, maybe it will help you, and then we will practice. Maybe let's go this. See? No.
Should
So today we're going to do a quick little active listening demonstration.
This is active listening skill. We will watch this and.
So today we're going to do a quick little active listening demonstration. And I'm going to be an observer, and Susan is going to play the role of coach, and Amar is going to play the role of coach.
Resolve the issue that she's struggling with and help her.